Okay, now we are starting with firmware architecture, how to use our library. For me, important part, and at the end of the day we will finish with some tip and tricks and etc. Or you can have a look to the document. Part about firmware architecture, firmware structure, firmware organization. It's a bit change from the previous library, because now we are based on the AHL library, and our software development team define some different way how to look to the application. We have this parts. One, it's user interface library. It's mean some user communication with the protocol, LCD display or DAC output. That's some debug functionality, which is not really necessary to use in a real application. That's our part of user interface. Then they name the control like a cockpit, and the last one it's a motor control library. The motor control cockpit, the most important part is and contains also with three parts. First it's some interface. The motor control interface, we have two motors, we need start both and etc. Then we have some configuration part. Small part, but important. We have to set up somehow our library, our peripheries, and last part it's some dynamics with some loops, and it's handled with some FOC task, high frequency, motor control medium, and some safety part. That's all about the structure. That's quite simplified, and now we switch to the API, application programming interface. What is the application programming interface? Setup of functions, yes, some definition of some structure or some variables and etc. Some interaction between your code and our library. Yeah, and it's exactly what is in this slide. We have some motor control firmware, our library, and we have to send some command, receive some information, some data from the application. We can split to two sections. One is some motor control user interface. That's some basic level, how to start the motor and etc. And the second one, it's some lower level programming interface. For example, we can start motor, stop motor. We already know that inside the library it's some ramp generator for the speed, and we can program, set up some parameter of this speed ramp controller. And then we can go deeply to the some a bit hidden stuff like PID regulators, and we can set up some parameter of the of this regulator. That's a necessary interface for that. Motor control interface contains two types of functions, and it's good to know it. One is buffered. That's a first part, and second one it's non-buffered, and different it's simply if we run a buffered command, for example program speed ramp. That's not execution, let's prepare some condition about the required ramp. We want to be at the exact speed we define it in this function after some time, and that's our definition, and it will be stored, and in the time that where is possible use it, if it motor running not in the open loop, in closed loop, we can use it. It is buffered, and we use this value when it's possible. And second one react quite immediately, that it's start motor, stop motor, but to be sure that it's not react exactly immediately, maybe acknowledge react immediately, because it's clear some flag which define that something happened that could be immediately. But start motor, define some flag that after this command, the library which is running on the interrupt service routine initiate the section what is necessary, switch on the PWM generation, and etc. etc. That it's take some time, and for that it's not a reaction immediately, but it's executed immediately. Then one part with example of interface, motor control interface, which is the top level. We have received a request mostly from China that our code is quite complex, it's difficult to use it, and for that our development team define this level of programming interface, which is quite similar. And define it like this one, that contains only the necessary parameters, final speed and ramp duration, and the rest is described in the name. That's the different. And second group is quite in the old style, but it is again quite simplified, and it contains also some pointer to some structure which is used inside. It's running on some structures which is used for the, in this case, for the PI speed regulator, and you have for that handle. You can find what is possible use inside in some mcconfig .h file. There is a list definition, because it's header file, of the external variables, and you can use it. There is about speed regulator, current regulator, temperature sensing, bus voltage, all stuff it's inside, and you can find what can you use inside. Then it's this one. Please don't forget use this one, because if you don't use include, you don't know this link. And you have to type include of this header. Okay, again, highlight variable formats, because in most cases customer forgot it and make it some disadvantage for that. Two formats for the speed, in 0.Hz or in pulse per PWM cycle. And you have to recalculate through this equal. At the end, it's multiplying, dividing by 6. That's a simple calculation. And for the speed ramp, you have to remember, take in account that we use milliseconds. And last one, it's digit per PWM. And last one, we maybe touch sometime with the playing with the workbench, that our torque current inside the online tool, it's in some units, that's not current in milliamps or amps, that in the some internal units, that signet integer, and you can calculate from the definition from power stage, which is contains a shunt value gain of the network and the VDD of micro. That's all you have to take in account. In our case, it's good luck, because we have power stage with current range which is up to 3.268, and the range of 16-bit integer, it's 32, 7, 6, and etc. That's only decimal point. That's good luck that we can imagine the current really directly from the number. But in real life, you will have bad luck and you have to calculate. But for today, we have this case. Okay, there is some example of code. You see some not logic step in this code. What will be happen? Then stop. Yeah, immediately you cancel the start. And then it's nice in this example. It's that there is possible see what we have inside that NTC the all functionality about NTC start with NTC underscore about the PID regulator again the common functions it start with MC bus voltage sensing and etc. That's good to know and you can easily find it. Okay, we have some help file which is in the section documentation and you have find all functions in the library with the description. This file is generated from the source code. You can find the same comment in the source code and it is on your decision if you want to use help file or search in the project. Both is possible and you will find the same information. Okay, then we have about 2 hours and because we usually have a lunch at 12 o'clock and we start with first part, we will see what is your possibility, how fast we can go through the examples and we will start now with the examples. We have just before we have some slides about hands-on and example projects. First part it's because it's usually engineers learn from examples and copy paste. It's a nice way to make own code, but to be sure to make some not good step. For the learning, it's good to have example, try, play with them, modify. And for that, we have examples in the structure, which is the same folder like installation folder in program files. And we can find there some examples. First example, it's quite similar to our first testing example, but a bit simpler. It is use speed ramp and repeatedly start the motor with some slope and after some time stop the motor. This example is prepared for combination Nucleo 303RE with our power stage AHM07 with bulk running motor. That's only control part is different, but I think it's easily to take the C code and use it also with this board. Then we have a second example, which is most close to our testing firmware with the potentiometer. And with this example, you can find some technique how to use some state machine, how to take value information from the system state that it's running or something else. And this example simply use analog input. That's good information from this example that we can use the same ADC converter for the user channel. It's necessary to take a micro with more ADCs if I want to define through the potentiometer position my speed. I can use the same, use only different input, and our motor control library on the background take care about this one, which is not time critical. And in this example, it's how to handle reading of the bus voltage that we have to define some channel, and then we can take a result of the conversion.